near reflex pathway. In this video, we'll talk about the anatomy of near reflex. When you looked at a close object, you get a near reflex. It is made up of two parts, a convergence reflex and an accommodation reflex. The convergence reflex is characterized by convergence of the visual axis of the eyes as well as pupil constriction or miosis. The accommodation reflex consists of increased accommodation and associated constriction of the pupil. Convergence, accommodation, and miosis are the three near reflexes. Let's start with the convergence reflex pathway. The afferent starts from the medial recti. This travels centrally via the third nerve to the mesencephalic nucleus of the fifth nerve. From here the impulses travel to the convergence center in the tectal or pretectal region. Internuncial fibers from the convergence center then go to the Edinger-Westphal nucleus. The efferent pathway is along the third nerve, similar to that of the light reflex. From the third nerve efferent fibers of convergence reflex relay in the accessory ciliary ganglion and from there reach the sphincter pupil. Next is accommodation reflex pathway. The afferent starts from the retina. Impulses go from the rods and cones to the optic nerve, optic chiasma and optic tract. Fibers then pass to the lateral geniculate body, optic radiations and striate cortex. The impulses reach area 19 of the occipital cortex. Internuncial fibers then pass from area 19 to the pontine center via the occipitomes and cephalic tract. From the pontine center fibers pass to the Edinger-Westphal nucleus of both sides. From the Edinger-Westphal nucleus the efferent impulses travel along the third cranial nerve and relay in the ciliary and accessory ciliary ganglion. From there the fibers reach the sphincter pupillae. If you find this video helpful, please hit the subscribe and bell buttons. And don't forget to like and share this video. Thanks.